Yo, what is up YouTube? Sharp here, bringing you guys another video, and I want to apologize because I haven't really been doing too many YouTube videos. I've been kind of slacking lately, mainly just because of streaming, and another reason is my team hasn't, we haven't really been playing that much of MW3. I've mainly been playing pubs, and a lot of you guys don't really like to see pubs, especially kill confirmed. You guys don't like when I play kill confirmed because I tend to go around the dog tags, especially if I'm going for Moab. But today, bringing you guys Sharpen Your Skills again. You guys seem to like this series. And we are playing on Bootleg. My team is Moho, Saints, and John. You guys obviously know them. And we're playing against Pac-Man, Mini Wheats, Reaction, and Blurred, I believe. Blurred X. The only two people on this team I really know is Pac-Man and Mini Wheats. They were Call of Duty 4 pros. And they played some in MW2 and then didn't really play Black Ops. The reason why I'm doing this video, Bootleg CTF, a lot of people, when I stream, they ask me, how does your team play Bootleg? And, this is a map that a lot of people have trouble on, so I figured, why not do a gameplay and talk about it. Something I really don't like about the theater is that you can't really do too much with the cinematics and stuff, so it's going to be kind of hard to show some stuff. I can't go into, a free-for-all and do all that stuff that I did for Black Ops, but... really, I'm just going to show the gameplay and then talk about it, what you should be doing. And really, what we do on this map, we have three people run SMGs, me, John, and Moho. Me and John like to use the MP7. On my MP7, sometimes I use range, sometimes I use focus, sometimes I use kick. It's really just whatever you prefer. John uses focus on his MP7, and then Moho uses the UMP with focus. What focus does, it makes it so when you get shot, your shot doesn't bounce up that much, so you can get those across map shots down. And I really don't see much of a difference in the proficiencies. Supposedly range is supposed to make it so your bullets hurt from farther away, so I guess it gives makes your bullets stronger. I don't know, but I'm using, I don't even know what I'm using this game. I guess I'll have to wait till I die. But like I said, three SMGs, and then Saints is running the assault rifle. He uses a ACR. That seems to work with us. We don't really lose Bootleg too much. As you see, Saints right here with his ACR with kick. We don't really tend to lose Bootleg too much, so that's why people ask me, how does our team play it so well? What you want to do is, you see right here, we have three people pushing the right side over here by a top patio. That's a call out for this top patio. Another quick little thing is, someone asked me if I'm going to be doing a call-out video. And I don't have all the call-outs done yet. Or, down pat. So, I will probably do the same thing I did for Black Ops. Once they figure out what the MLG maps are, and once, my team figures out what we're calling everything, then I'll, probably do a call-out video. But, what you want to do on this map is pretty much just flood patio side. You see Moho running in that easy cap right there. We had three people push patio. One of the guys that went patio went to top stairs and then looked down middle. And the other two guys pushed up to the far right, to the bricks and the chicken coop. And then we have our assault rifle guy, Saints. He pretty much just, watches street the whole time. He rotates back and forth from street and middle. I just kind of go off in this game with this gun. This gun's a beast. If you guys don't use it, I suggest you try using it. But really, the main focus on this map should be your patio side. You want to push back patio. They're always going to be spawning back here right on their flag, and they're going to get behind that dumpster head glitch. That dumpster that I was shooting at right there, you can just look right over that and shoot the flag, which is kind of annoying. But if you can take control of the building that I was just in right there, you should be able to get an easy cap. As you see, I got a three-piece. Always run the flag patio. You can sometimes run it middle if you get four dead, but they're spawning on this side. After you pull the flag, they're going to be spawning back left street. So if you run middle, that gives you the opportunity to get stunned. And that's what your assault rifle there guy is there for, is to watch street. I don't know how that guy slipped through, but got the cap. Doesn't really matter. And also, mainly these CTF maps, you want to treat them like they are, like the Black Ops maps. You want to always push back. Sometimes you can overextend and go middle. But for the most part, you want to try to push back right here. And I hate shooting through these little market things. I don't really like little banana stands. We have three people down right now. Luckily, John comes up clutch. And there's not really enough time for them to go and catch the flag. So, we're going to be going on the second side here. Me personally, I think that the side we're on right now is the better side just because of the spawn we get. You don't spawn out in the left, out in the open of the street. I mean, you do still spawn on the street, but you know, there is better places to set up in your base. There's more head glitches, and you can just, you know, you can just chill there and wait for your team to run back. Now you'll see on this side, you want to do the same thing on this side. Push patio, mainly. You see off the start here, me and John are kind of going middle. I wanted to kind of hesitate towards patio, but I decided to go up the top stairs right here and go patio. Moho pushed up left side, and Saints is watching the far right street. Now the reason why I say use, you know, SMGs are better on this map is because this is a close range map. There's going to be more, you know, tightly enclosed areas where you're going to need an SMG to get this shit done. Saints is running ACR watching the street, so you know the street's pretty much wide open. You got to get people out of head glitches, so that's why, you know, that's why you need that one assault rifle guy. But other than that, I wouldn't really want to overdo it on the assault rifles. I know a lot of teams like to use those, and we don't really use the Type 95 just because we feel that if it doesn't get banned, then it'll most likely suck. And if after it gets nerfed, I don't think it got nerfed yet. You know, they had that update. I don't really know what that update did. And if it was the nerf to Type 95, then they didn't really do anything. But if after it gets nerfed, if it hasn't already been nerfed, then, and if it's still good, then most likely I think MLG will ban it. And I know what a lot of you guys are thinking, that, you know, MLG hasn't banned a gun really, but really the only problem with the FAMAS is that everyone used it. I know that with the Type 95, people won't, you won't have everyone in the game using the Type 95. It's just that the person that is using it can get like a one burst kill. Like, what's the point? Like, at least the FAMAS took, you know, somewhat skill. The only reason why people really want to push for the FAMAS ban is just because you would have 4-on-4 FAMAS and it would just be boring to watch. It wasn't because it was overpowered or anything. That was the main reason, but I think the Type 95 truly is overpowered, and it only takes one burst to kill somebody. Now you see we're pulling the flag here, and really, sometimes on this, you know, when you're pulling on this side, you don't necessarily always want to pull at patio. You want to kind of pull it to wherever your team is. So maybe if we have, you know, if we spawn street and we pushed up and our guy gets a pull, and he runs street, then that'll be fine. You just have to cut off the patio side in the middle. You can actually, you know, running up middle actually really works on the side, just because they do spawn over here in this little left side room that you're looking at, where I get the two piece, that little room over there with the cage and the head glitch. I think that's where B demo is on demolition. They do spawn over here in this area, and they do spawn over there by patio courtyard. So it is kind of, you know, pesky, and they can spawn right here in front of Saints. You know, Saints is getting some spawn kills down. So it really is just, you just want to pull on the side wherever your team is. Now, like I said, on the other side, you always want to pull patio. So take note of that. Don't always want to pull patio when you're pulling, when you're on the team that I'm on right now, pulling from, I don't really know what to call that side. Opposite of chicken coop, I don't know. But, you know, just pull wherever your team has controlled. I can't emphasize that enough. As you see, we have four down. Maybe it'll show right here, them spawning up. With the weird spawns, most likely right now they'll spawn street. You know, you see John killing him on the street. So I don't want to have everyone on our team push up into the base, so I'm kind of just checking over here. I think people actually, yeah, you see right there, he spawned right there. Take notice of your mini map when you're playing too. That's a big thing to notice. I see there's no one on our team over here, so I start to push over there a little bit, thinking they're gonna spawn there. He called out a guy behind him. I turned around, got the guy behind him, and then the guy did spawn over there. So really, all this game is, the minimap really helps out in this game. You want to spread your team out. Any empty areas, assume that the other team is going to spawn there. Because the way they did the spawns in this game, it's not like Black Ops where, let's take firing range, for example. Everyone's going to be spawning over by CDOM on CTF. It's not like that. They did it the way in this game that you're not going to be able to get spawn killed, really. You're going to be spawning where there's a gap in the map. So right now they're probably on the street. They're probably spawning the street side because we have a guy in mid-alley. John's pushing in their back thing, and I was over in patio courtyard. But I did get taken out by the guy that was up top patio. So really, big thing that you guys should be paying attention to is the mini map. Spread your team out, look for the spawns, and you should be able to dominate CTF as my controller falls asleep in the theater mode. I don't know why it does that. Never did it on Black Ops. Kind of weird. I really hope they update the theater mode just because I think it makes it harder to make videos such as this. You know, you can't really be as descriptive. I haven't really played around with it, so I'm not 100% sure if you can fly around in free mode. But we did win that map. It was a good game to them. This is just from Scrubs, by the way. And once again, I apologize. I'm going to be trying to, upload a video a day. Even on the weekends, I'll try to get a video out. This is Sharp, 22 and 16. I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, please give it a like, add it to your favorites, and subscribe if you're not subscribed. Sharp, I'm out. Peace.